I have 5 minutes to show you something great, so let's go through it quickly. I think that functional programming, as many of the hands showed, is now very popular, and I believe in it. I think it makes things much more easier to work with. And it's even more sweeter when you have types with your functional programming style. And that's why people like Elm, that's why people like ReasonML. And that's why it's also sometimes difficult to do this stuff in pure JavaScript or in TypeScript. What I want to show you is this library called fpts by Giulio Canti. It's a set of types and some utilities you can use to have all these sweet patterns and data structure you use in these truly functional languages in TypeScript. And it's not just this library, this is the base of that, but there are more of those, including the IOTS and a Monocle, if you know Monocle from... Monocle from other languages. It's also there. I want to show you an example. I will show you code later even. The example is a sign up form. Like, this is a pain. Like, we all have forms on our websites. We all have forms. And what forms need is validation. And that's difficult till this day. Even though we have some libraries that can somehow assert that something is for example, email or a phone number, what happens after you validate this form is you come to your JavaScript, and then you have functions, and it's a string. The only annotation you can do, usually, is do a string. And then it's very unsafe. You can call this function with any string. You have no guarantee it's going to be an email. So what do you do? Will you do a runtime check? Will you do it for every function that wants email? It's crazy. What will you do if it's not an email? Will you throw? Will you destroy your application? I have a solution. I will show you something. It will blow your mind. It did mine. I can create a type which makes sure this function is always called with a valid email address. And I can know it at compile time. I will show you. It's some magic in there. In functional programming, we usually distinguish between the ugly world outside and the beautiful, pure world inside. And on the border, we have this border patrol, and it's called I/O, input-output. It makes sure that we translate the ugly things to the nice things nicely. And there is this, I already told about that, there is a library called IOTS. And we can use that to create something which is called branded type. And that will be the email I talked about. And it has three arguments. The first one is what type it's based on. So in our case, for email, it's a string. Then you pass a rather magical part, which is still pure TypeScript. It's called type check, I hope. And here you pass something, and a return is Boolean if the thing is the email. So here I only validate it's an email. It looks weird, but it's small magic. And then you name it for debugging purposes. Also, what you get from this is the actual type you can use in your type system. So what happens is that the structure has a function called decode. And you can pass anything to it, anything. And it will make sure that the result is email. But what if it's not, right? Will I throw? No, I don't want to throw. Then we have another type in functional programming, a pattern called either. And either has two parts. It's left or right. And left is for errors, and right is right, meaning is the correct one. And you can make sure that when you call something, you have to handle the wrong state. We have to handle the error. That's very important. And again, the library I talked about has some nice utilities for that. So what you can do fault, and then you have to handle the case when it's actually fail, and you have to handle the case when it fails, and maybe show an error or do something else. The important thing, it's very visible, and it's very safe for you. And now comes the great thing. In TypeScript, if I ever try to use email directly, the type, I will get an error. This is compile time error. This is what it makes it like so great. That means that anything that has type email has at least once in its lifetime had to pass successfully the validation check. And you can be sure of that. And TypeScript makes sure that has happened during your coding. And that's just great. Let me go through the benefits again. The first thing, it's very readable. you have a function that accepts email. You have it in the type, so everybody can know, oh, it's actually working with emails, not just a string. It's checked on compile time. Again, for me, this is like the biggest magic. So TypeScript can make sure that this function receives valid email during your working statically in your IDE. Great. And it's just TypeScript. We are not introducing a new language. You don't have to learn new stuff. You can use all the libraries available on NPM, which have either TypeScript or JavaScript or whatever else is on NPM. You can just use that. Nothing very special. And because it's just TypeScript, it's fully a full stack, meaning it works in browser, it works in on server, it works everywhere JavaScript runs. And you can be sure it works. Actually, the example I showed you is built using this. You see that you can kind of understand what is there, how things should be validated. And we have this use form hook, which kind of does some magic. And the full example, I will show you a link to it later. The problem with this, with the whole fpts, is if you look into that, it's math. It's just math, a lot of mathematics. And it's very difficult to get into it. I say it's always like, if you want to learn CSS by reading the specification, don't do that. You would need a workshop. And that's what we actually want to do. So we have this website called typescript.fun. Me and my friend put it together this week. So it's very brief. We just have an email sign up for and the link to the example. If you are interested, I would love to talk to you at this conference, or I would like to see you on Twitter or anywhere else. Thank you very much.